Welcome, welcome, welcome. Today I'm working on Velle's cave, NPCs. How you guys been today, by the way? Teak, PFC? Oh, let me get the sound going. What's up, Boogie? Yeah, so today I'll be working on this cave where Velle is. I want to take away these plants. You know, plants don't really grow inside caves. There's something wrong with the Z, too. You can see up here in these plants right here aren't looking that good. But anyways, I'm taking them out anyways, so. Yeah, so this is how it will go. Basically, you can talk to her. She's floating in cryo sleep, but she's somewhat conscious, so she can actually communicate with you telepathically because she's partially telepathic. So, anyways, but eventually throughout the game, you get the blink orb, and you have to get the blink orb extender to be able to blink up here. What's up, Jonah? And, oh yeah, and once again, this is kind of a kind of spoiler alert once again. So I'm working on stuff that, you know, that would basically spoil the game a little bit if you want to know all the secrets and stuff. So, but anyways, yeah. So you warp up here. I'm thinking this is how it'll go. You get the second blink orb. So you need two blink orbs to get over to this, and then you drop a bomb, and that will finally wake her up. Or, like, fully get her out of cryo sleep. So, and then she's central to the plot and all that, so. Uh-huh. The live stream of the Kickstarter getting funded, I notice. Oh, back in the day, that one? Professional Novice is still here every once in a while, and so is Zelda Ethan. Okay, so I also want to get the patterns going for this. So the Velle's Cave is a bunch of different areas. It's three different areas here. This is Velle's Cave in this world. It might look totally different in different worlds because, you know, this might be a different area type, you know, biome or whatever. So you go inside the cave, and then there's this room. This is like the central room. There's another room on the right. And this is going to be for a cryo chamber, which has a big hole in it. Like, some creature came out of this, and you're like, what? Yeah, it's true, Boogie. Yeah. And then this cave right here will have another warrior floating in cryo sleep. And I'm pretty sure... I got a thought that maybe you can fight him eventually, but... I'm probably going to make it so he's just a total mystery for this entire game. All of Songbringer, the first game. If there is ever a second game, I'll turn him into like a second, like into a crazy warrior. So there'll be some kind of like, he'll be linked to the next game. And then Velle is essential to this game. So, the Kraken, right? He'd be like a Kraken guy. Nice, Teak. Nice. Three screens. Okay, so first of all, I'm gonna take make some patterns out of this stuff. I just upgraded to Cocos to Xcode 7.3, so I'm kind of getting used to it here. Yeah, so I got some patterns. I'm finally going to make a pattern, a special pattern for the sword. That should have been there the whole time. You only have two eyes? that's definitely not going to spoil song. If there is a Songbringer 2, that comment there definitely did not spoil the game. That's just, he's more of a secret character. I haven't even drawn him yet. But yeah, he'll be a secret character basically in the second game. And he's kind of like a, what's that in this game? All right, so I'm going to lay out these patterns. Got sword, Velle's overworld pattern, Velle's connector, Velle's Velle pattern. This is where she's actually at. The mysterious warrior. And the empty cryo chamber. All right. I want to also double check that I got all these other patterns. Oh, man. Xcode's new jump to thing is all broken. It's kind of pissing me off. I use that jump to like crazy all the time. So now I have to press Command O to bring it up, and then I have to press the down arrow key to go to the selection that it's already on. Used to be smart and just it was only one button press. Ah, que sera, sera. What's up, Marza? How you doing, Marza? Connector Island. Make sure all these are in here. Here we go. Blank none. Connector Island. Two islands. Isthmus four dots. Diagonal lines. Isthmus four dots X. Diamond maze diagonal lines. Stairs item switch before boss 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 on side boss hole go. Great, cool. We got all the patterns definitely named here. Nice, nice, nice. I know, Boogie, right? Oh, Mars, all right, man. Well, good night. Have a good night. Thanks for saying hi. Hey, Alex Pita. You're on the iPad? All right, man. Thanks for saying hi. Bufu is not kill. That needs to be a quote right there. Bot foos not kill. That's pretty awesome. All right, so next thing, I just want to use these patterns. So I got a special sword pattern, overworld patterns, all the things for Velle. Twitch ain't working? What? Let's make sure this still runs. You can't go to sleep now? Yes! Quoted! Alright. So yeah, everything's still working. Okay. Jigs! Jigs! Yes! All right. So next in world. Oh no, they really broke. Oh my god. I guess. Oh man. Apple. All right. So here's Velle's cave. It goes and creates a Z level for Velle's cave. And then it creates the maze Z. It does some special magic to set up the right pattern. And then here it goes and loops over each one of the rooms. So in here, in this, we want to put some special patterns for Velle's cave. So if it's an interest Z, is interest, oh, actually we could just do is interest, this places Z and K interest Vel. P to X is 0. P to Y is 0. The pattern is K pattern Vel Warrior. I guess we could probably do a flip here, but we'll do that last. Like it might flip the cave over. Hello, Mike DeString. Game looks gorgeous. Thank you, man. Thanks for saying that. Thanks that for that a lot. Appreciate it. I'm working on Vel's Cave today. This is a cave where you finally will have NPCs. So it's been a long time. Haven't got really any NPCs in the game yet. But this version coming out this Wednesday to Steam will finally have some NPCs. This is Vel's Cave. Vel is the central character to the game. And she's floating in cryo sleep when you first meet her. But you can talk to her. You can talk to her telepathically. You don't know why. Marza, have I added something cool to the engine? Something notable and publicly disclosable? Yes. Yes, let me show you something really cool lately. Here's something really neat. The shadows are a lot better. Check out all the shadows. First of all, they flicker in the light of the flames. See how they're flickering right now? So that's pretty cool. Second of all, they're way more dynamic. So what, see how I'm lighting off these different fires and like all these different shadows and stuff? That's pretty cool. And then check this out too. If I eat a cactus, the shadows get partially psychedelic colored. So check this out. See how those shadows are green, some of them are purple, some are orange. It's kind of hard to tell, but whenever you eat the cactuses, the shadows get psychedelic colored, so that's kind of cool. So yeah, I've been doing a lot of work on shadows lately. And they've really improved a lot. I also improved their performance too, so their performance is a lot better than it used to be. And there's some more work I can do to optimize them even further, because shadows are actually becoming really expensive to render now, because I'm rendering so many of them. I'm rendering a lot of shadows per entity, and then there's a lot more entities which I'm throwing shadows on. Like, I mean, even Vel's like chamber thing here. Wait, he used to have a shadow. Should have a third shadow for Jib here. Yeah, there's something wrong with the shadow in this room. Oh well, yeah, so that's what I'm working on. That's some of the cool stuff lately. Can you be communicating with someone in stasis so their brain is active so they notice the time of being movable thousands of years? That's horrifying. So Teague, okay, so what happened is Vel is partially, she's partially telepathic. So when her backstory is she's a great warrior from the previous war, the Great War. The Great War ended on this planet, Xera. And she was an incredible warrior, and she had trained with this master that allowed her to become telepathic and allowed her to use her chi powers and stuff to shoot energy beams and stuff like that out of her hands. So she's floating in cryosleep for 10,000 years, yes, but she's not fully awake. She's like in a really deep meditative state. So for her, one day passes like in a minute. So that's why it's not really too much for her. But she can and she can't see, so sure, her eyes are closed, her body is essentially shut down mostly. It's just that her mind is still aware. So she can communicate telepathically if there's someone nearby. She can kind of sense what's going on in their mind a little bit and communicate with them a little bit, but not at her normal conscious level. So that's kind of what I'm thinking of for this character here. Jonah, you keep saying the statues need to face each other. I don't know. I don't like perfect symmetry. So that's why I have some of the statues facing, not each other. The trademark sign. What's up, Pedro? So yeah, I'm gonna finish getting these patterns going. This is X2, Y0, this is the Velle empty. And then the middle one, X1, this is the Velle connector. But if he can communicate telepathically, you mean she? Her brain must be active, and when her mind is slowed down so far, she could not notice when someone tries to contact her, since it is, for her, so extremely short. Well, for her, what happens is when someone tries to communicate, if she notices that there's someone there, sure, a day might go by in a minute, but she brings herself, she can bring herself out of being super deep, or she can be, you know, she can bring her mind a little bit out of the cryo sleep. She's very strong. She's like an incredibly strong mentally, and she's a great warrior. So basically, yeah, she can make it so a day goes by in a minute, and she can also speed her brain back up so it can kind of communicate at our level. Is the trademark symbol trademarked? What? Etherologic, what does that even mean? Marge's got me looking up a word here. Etherologic. Urban Dictionary. The study of living your life with balance and grace. Cool. Balance and grace. All right, so P.x equals 1. Yeah, I realize it might be a bit of a far stretch, but that's what video games are, man. You got to stretch a little. You got to think outside the box. Everything can't be perfectly explainable. But in a sense, I still want things to be explainable. So for me, all right, there's a big talk on this. Like, there's sci-fi, and then there's science fantasy. You know what I mean? Star Trek is science fiction. Star Wars is more science fantasy because there's the Force and all this stuff. There's these mystical powers. Songbringer is more of a science fiction fantasy rather than a regular science fiction science-y thing. You know? I do try and explain things, how the technology works in most instances, but still, there's going to be the mystic powers, and I totally believe in mystic powers myself, and I think that as our human race evolves, you know, tens of thousands of years down the road, things will be more like things that we would call, you know, superpowers right now for humans will become more commonplace, and people will know how to develop those skills. Our brains will evolve. You know, we will actually, even at just a 2% increase in brain power, and we could do a bajillion more things. So I believe eventually this will happen for our race, and I believe it happened in the past in this story. So that's why Songbringer is a science fiction fantasy, not a science fiction science game. And so I hope that's clear there, you know. Sci-fi. Yeah, well, personally, I think it is explainable, but you and other people might think it's not explainable if something goes to the mystic level. Like, for you, do you think that telepathy is something that is not explainable with science? Because for me, I think telepathy is explainable with science. I I sound like a Mass Effect fan. What is the? I haven't. Is that? That's a game, right? It's called Mass Effect. Yeah, I know there's a game called Mass Effect, but I just haven't played it. Mass Effect. Which one's that? Does it have a lot of like science fantasy stuff as well? Like, do they use mystical powers and telepathy and mind control and stuff like that? Looks very science fiction-y. What's up, Silly Billy Bear? Oh, they also have awesome lore? Cool. Nice. Yeah, well, I really want to put a lot of lore into this world. All right, so Velle, this is the Velle pattern. Okay, so now we should have patterns appropriate to this area, but it shouldn't be adding any of them just yet. The Grelling-Nelson paradox. Heterological meaning inapplicable to itself. Wow, this is interesting, man. This is something I need like a few days to process, though. Sounds deep. Okay, so if I run this, everything should still be the same. We've got these patterns set up, but I don't think they'll be in use just yet. Yeah, this is not in use. But we got still got that. Okay, good. Now we gotta get these patterns being used. In area patterns. Hey, that one worked. Now I only had to press one button to get that to work. It's like, oh, here it is, add pattern. All right, so I think add pattern is only called from a couple different places. Here's one of them. Yeah, pattern connector, that's right. And then this one, pattern level random, right? Okay, so yeah, we want to add a pattern to the caves. Pattern cave. Sword, interest types, secret stuff. Here's where we're adding the pattern. Hello, Demi user. What's up? Welcome. Welcome to the stream, man. Okay, so now we're adding the pattern. Still, we shouldn't have anything. But if we do this, and then add in a pattern for Velle. Else if pattern, K pattern, Velle. Let's come with this out, and now when we run it, we should have no more Velle, but then we'll add her back in. Right, so she's gone. Let's put her back in with this pattern now. So now we don't need to do this janky stuff here with this if area x pause, blah, blah, blah. Get rid of that nonsense. And here. There's this Velle's position. Here's where we put some sky around her platform and then set the tiles for her area. So that should make it so she has a pattern now. Nice, Demi user. Cool. Right on, man. I'm looking forward to making this game as awesome as possible. And personally, I am getting to be quite pleased with this video game. My last few play sessions, like, I've spent like a good hour and a half getting deeper and deeper into a certain world. I think the world I've been doing is called Tuxedo. And I've been having a lot of fun playing Songbringer personally. And that's saying a lot because I typically get very bored with games fast. That's why I'm making this a procedurally generated game. I want it to be able to surprise me every time I play it. And that's why I think it's appealing to a lot of people too. So anyways, I just want to make it more and more and more awesome. I want to make this the best game I could possibly make. So yeah, we got the pattern working now. All right. And what if we were to do these other patterns? So Velle's cave is fleshed out now. What's up, Android U? Thanks, man. What's up, Space My Name? So what if the connector pattern, the one in the middle, as a center point here, and we'll just throw some sky everywhere. No Velle, no gargoyles. Now that I've ruined the chat, I can fly away. Fly away, Marza! Fly into sleepland! Great. Okay, so now we just got some random sky here in the middle. That's good. So the patterns are working. We got an empty pattern over there. An empty pattern over here. And the Velle pattern up here. Great, so now I want to take this pattern here in the middle and make this a little smaller. Actually, I just want to make it a circle. Or a diamond, maybe a diamond. No, let's draw a circle. I think I already got this a pattern called pattern shape, which draws circles and stuff. You're working on procedure generated solar systems, sweet. It's easier than you expected, right? It's not that bad. Procedurally generated games are not too difficult, you know? So put it at position, K, shape, circle, width. Thinking like 3 by 3, maybe 4 by 3. And a circle of tile sky. Let's comment that out, this out. We should just have a circular hole. You'll still be able to go back in time? Nice. It does have a very high ceiling. Okay, so it's a little too... it's not circular enough for me. Nope. So I think we need another position on the height there, and maybe another one on the width. Nice PMC, right on. I'm looking forward to the update coming out. That was good. So once again, there's an update coming out to Songbringer tomorrow night. We're talking 36 hours from now, there'll be an update for Songbringer on Steam. Man, why didn't it do a circle again? No one cry for me. What's this? Alright, yay, it's actually a circle this time. I'm thinking bigger now. Let's go a whole 7 wide and 7 tall. Android U, all 63 files are not being compiled every time. It's only compiling one file each time. It just says 62 of 63 because it's updating one of them. I know it's confusing, but it's Xcode being confusing, that's all. Yeah, there we go. Now we have a hole in the middle, which is kind of mysterious. And eventually what I'm going to do to the art here is to make these edges deeper so you'll be able to see, like, three times as much of an edge there. And it'll go down into blackness, but you'll still be able to see a little bit more of the edge. Right now, there's just too much blackness. So what else could we do to this room to make it cool? Well, I'm glad you asked. Nice, you should show us a link to your gifts, man. What's up, Felix? Can you play the game now if you backed it on Kickstarter? Yes, you can if you backed it at the $32 level. Or if you want, if you backed it at the any of the levels below that, like the $16 or the other one too, that's the early backer, $8 run. Either one of those, you can just upgrade if you want. If you really want to play it right now, you want to play the beta, just go to songbringer.com, pre-order. Songbringer.com/pre-order. And there's an upgrade button. So at the bottom, there's this upgrade buy now button. Or you can always just order another $16 copy and I'll merge your two together. So I can merge your existing Kickstarter backing and your purchase or whatever. And we'll put those together into one and I'll send you a Steam code for the game right now. So your Steam code, whenever you get a Steam code for Songbringer, it's permanent. So it always gives you access to the game from now on. So if you get a Steam code now, you get to play the game now during the beta, and you'll still get you'll still own the game when it comes out. You get the fully released game too, of course. All right. So now I want to do some more. Now that I've got some good patterns, let's call this special patterns. I think I separated out this section. Yeah, this is levels. All right, Marza. See you, man. In pattern cave. Let's see if that works. Oh, it almost worked, but no. I gotta press up a bunch. Dude, Xcode, man. Xcode ruined the freaking quick open in 7.3. Bastards. I mean, they didn't ruin it, but still, it's just a lot harder to use. Here's the secret Z. I have a special pattern already for sword, don't I? No, I don't. Never mind. So we would want to do this. And then in Velle's connector pattern, we have some special lights. Let's see how that's looking. Yeah, Demi. Yes. It's more of a little video series. It's on, if you're a programmer and you want to learn how to do art, that's my introduction to how to become an artist being a programmer first, from that perspective, you know. Yeah, so let's move those lights now to the edge of the circle. So it's going to be H2 minus 1. Well, let's put it right at P. P dot Y. It's also P dot Y. Do I use any scripting language like Lua? No, there's no scripting languages whatsoever. It's all C++. Unless you count the behavior trees I wrote, which are, you could call the behavior trees their own language, I guess. Like, here's one. This is a behavior tree. This is kind of its own language, but not really. What's up with the bell tree not working? That usually does, right? Yeah, there we go. Now we got some lights right here. Let's put them a little closer to the middle there. That would be 10 over 2 is 5. Yeah, that's just right there. So this would be W2 minus 5. And this would be plus 5, I think. Let's make sure that's still working. Great, cool. I like this little pattern now. So you come into this cave from outside here. This will look totally different in different worlds. Yeah, you guys can hear that, cool. And then you got this introductory pattern here. Bells up here. There'll be two more cryo chambers over this way and this way. So we don't need this stuff, and I wanted, now that I'm using these special patterns as they're meant to be, I need to do one for the sword. Meow too. Dim user, it's gonna be a long way. My current art level is this. Hey, that's not bad, man. That's a good start. Yeah, good job, man. Avaxin, what's up? I do remember you, man. And Protito, what's up, you guys? Hey, it's been a long time. There's been so many people visiting the stream from like a year ago. What's up, you guys? How you been? You guys were some of the very first people to ever watch Songbringer being streamed and being created at all. The game's come a long way since you guys have seen it, man. There's like, have you guys seen any of this stuff? You got fire swords, fire top hat, all these different like things you can warp and bombs and lots going on in the game now. Yeah, it's changed a lot. It's changed a lot. It's really come along. It's super procedural now. Before it wasn't as like awesome in its proceduralness. But it's getting a lot better. Okay, so I wanna go back. This is Vel's cave here. I wanna go to the main cave. And we'll go in here. Yeah, this room right here needs more lights now. And it needs to keep this edge, so I gotta make sure this is all working. Pattern sword. We're gonna need these two tiles. And I think I still need to set this pattern to make it work, though. Hundred plus hours, really? Whoa, Nuclear Throne, Spelunky. Oh, they're all procedural, right? Yeah. I'm glad you like procedural, too. I love procedural. I think procedural is a cool way to make games. And I hope that more developers start to make really, really well-crafted procedurally generated games, because the more time you spend on your procedural algorithms and stuff to create your world, the more it's going to be a truly procedurally generated game. I've seen, you know, like some procedural games, you know, they just basically take patterns and they reuse them everywhere, so that it's not really a procedurally generated game. It's more of a randomly arranged game. And so I'm really looking forward to the further iterations of procedurally generated games where Like Songbringer, for example, is it goes all the way down to the tile level to where it procedurally generates everything. So I'm really hoping that more games start to do that and really focus on the procedural part of it to make it really, really well crafted. And there are some really, really well crafted procedural games, and none of us can really take credit for it. I mean, it's been done for a long time. For example, Diablo. Diablo is a great game. It was also procedurally generated. Think about how awesome that game was. More explosions? Yes, there's more explosions. Plenty explosions. Hey, what's up, Narcos? Yeah. Totally. You either need a ton of content or you need a good algorithms. All right, so the pattern sword needs to be applied to. Oh man, this is the one world. You type in world and you have to like. Sorry, I'm complaining. Got the ship Z. Home. Oh, here it is. Cool. So we'll go exit desk, blah, blah, blah. Pattern is K, pattern sword. Screen shakes, never enough, right? You got to have tons of screen shakes. Thanks, Android. Yeah, it's true. I'm glad you said that, man. I'm glad you appreciate the art of this, man. Yeah, the art is. And there's an art to the procedural generation part of it too, you know? Code itself is art. Great. Now we got these pillars back. All right, so the other thing that this cave needs is to move the sword itself into that pattern. So I think I got K tile sword. Yeah, here it is. Yeah, so I'm moving everything that had to do with the sword. Oh, these fire pillars as well. These need to be. Guess we would want to go if pattern equals K pattern none, then we're going to just by default always have at least two fire pillars inside a cave. And then we'll go back to pattern sword and we add this stuff. So it's got a tile sword, two more of these pillars, and this is width, this is height. Okay, so we should still have the same sword pattern. Narcos, what game were you working on, man? I'm interested in checking out your game. One day, my children or grandchildren will watch these streams for coding school. Nice. Nice. All right, Demi, see you, man. Okay, so something happened here. This is why does it have this weird stuff up there? It must have something to do with this code I just reworked there. That was H. Was that supposed to be H2? No. What is W and H from where I just stole that code from? Pattern cave. H was height. Yeah, it was just height. That's weird. What was the purpose of this code then? Whoops. What's this supposed to do? X is 0 less than width. X if x is greater than or equal to W2, x is less than or equal to da da da. Oh, pff, I don't need that. This is supposed to make an opening in the bottom. I think. It's a 2D side scroller shooter, early in development. Right on, man. You got any screenshots or a website you could share or something? Yeah, check it out. We still got this sword pattern and everything. Shit. should be good. And if I were to go like this, like take out the sword, for example, that should be the only place in the code where it's ever placing the sword. Oh, it's disabled? All right, man. Cool. Well, I would love to take a look sometime whenever you got some screenshots up. Great. Okay, so now we don't have any sword as well. If I were to take off like all these, that should be the only light pillars we see in that cave. Oh, it has Twitch viewers as zombies. Oh, that's cool. Cool concept. All right, great. So yeah, that took out the fire. And also, if I go to the other caves where they had a pattern none. All right, Narcos. Cool. I'm looking forward to it. Great. Now go check out this other cave. Like, even this one. Well, this is just going to be a store. Yeah, that's still good. We got a different... Oh, this is a good example of how I want the sky tiles to sort of look like this. Just taller. This has a nice little backdrop right here where it's... You can see the ground dropping away and all that. You have a screenshot where I attack you as a zombie? Cool. Here's a cave, for example, where you would have bombed into this cave. Inside this cave, we should have two light pillars. Yeah, we still have the light pillars there and there. And we have a good pattern there as well. Okay, so now we'll go back to Vel's cave. Yeah, good. And we have this nice pattern here, starting for her. Yeah. Wait, I gotta make sure this is... Yeah, there's nothing there in the bottom. We're all looking... Yeah, looking good. Okay. Awesome. Man, I've been meaning to do this for a long time. Basically, what I just did here is I moved things out of a function and into a sub-pattern, basically. These are not patterns in the sense as more they're just algorithms. They work flexibly based on what's around them and stuff. So anyways, this is going to be better for the future. Better design. All right, so we'll clear this. Make sure I'm good, and I'll check what I got it done so far. Check this in. Oh, also we need to check one more Z level, the entrances. So I think that's negative, is it negative 11? Yeah, okay, good. Everything is still looking fine here at, oops, nope, we're broken. Oh, that's because this might be a negative like 11 or 12 and it's not actually in use. Let's find another level. Yeah, here we go. This has an exit. Okay. Yeah, so we got area 410, exit to 00, negative 12. And this thing has its own patterns. Or does it? It might not have its own pattern. I don't know. I guess it's all looking fine. So I can go back to Vel's cave, which is negative 300. And check it in and then start the other patterns and also make I'm gonna take the plants off of the mountains here. All right, so I moved the code out of those non-cohesive functions and into proper patterns, basically. So that basically I could set the pattern somewhere else, higher up in the logic of the game, in the world creation. I could say, all right, I want this area to have this pattern, that pattern. Great. Yeah. So we'll call this just Velle patterns. All right, next up, let's take the plants off the top. And create mountain tile. It decides whether it should do plants. And I'm going to change this so it has to be outdoors. So this would be this get outdoorness. It's greater than zero. So an area has to be outdoors if it's creating a mountain tile, so put plants. Yeah, there we go. Now we just have some rocks. Now, I think I do want to change this so it actually does some different kinds of plants, because I kind of miss it. It'd be nice to have some kind of like indoor cavey plants or something like that. But actually, it kind of does look cool. Maybe there could be something else on the walls, or I don't know. We'll call that good for now. Oh, I want to make sure that the mountains still work outside, too. Any progress? Yep. A little bit of progress. Just made some patterns for Velle's cave and made the patterns working. Okay, yeah, so everything's working just fine. I can see that these mountains have some bushes on top and stuff. So we're all good. Great. Now I'll finish up the patterns for the other two areas. So there's Velle. It's 2042 now. Velle. We got Velle. Warrior and Velle empty. So for both of these, we're just gonna have Velle. Actually, let's not do Velle just yet. It's all fine now. It's all good. Okay, so in this right room, we should now have another pattern. Yeah. But no Velle. That's cool. Over here, we should also have another pattern. Once again, no Velle, no cryo chamber just yet. But next step will be to add the cryo chamber to those rooms. And then we'll pretty much have this cave looking almost done, almost fleshed out. It'd be cool if this pattern... flames on the right. Let's do that. So, warrior pattern. This is W2 plus, blah, blah, plus that. Here. Let's see if that worked. Can I donate my kidney? Man, that's a really valuable thing to donate. You sure? You sure about this, man? That's a big step. Okay, so the minus one, I must have put it. This must have been the wrong. What's wrong with that? H2. Oh, this is H2 over 2. I'm want this to be just H2. All right, if you want. All right, Narcos, see ya. Later. Yeah, that's kind of interesting to see the lights here on the right instead. Kind of breaks up the pattern of this whole area a little bit. Yeah, Will. Do I prefer a liver? I think I'm gonna go ahead and take the kidney. Alright, now I just want to make it based on the position. So this is now gonna be P.Y. And I want to do this for the other cave as well. W2. So now these should have complementary fire pillars. This is kind of a symmetrical world. This little cave here is kind of symmetry. It really just depends if you drink more water or alcohol, doesn't it? Oh, I messed up on the minus plus. I think it's supposed to be 0 and 4, actually. 0, 4, both these. Have I turned off the ambient music? No, I haven't. This is just a cave with less ambience than usual. You can hear it though. There's an ambient music playing. It's this, like this sound, sort of mysterious noise. Okay, that was wrong. 3-1. Yeah, there we go. Now they're centered. Nice looking. Now we just gotta bring a cryo chamber into here. Alright, let's do it. We're gonna need 2 new tiles. So, in constants, it's K-tile Vel. K-tile Vel Warrior and the K-tile Vel Empty. What's up, everybody? Oh no, I forgot. I have to hook up a function for these too. Yeah. It's probably poor design here. So I'm just looking at these methods. Got it in the area.h. Now we get this, so we can actually create these tiles. And this should be able to be just entirely an auto entity. So I can create this entirely from data. It's called Velle Warrior. And then Velle Empty. And going to entities, I'm going to flesh it out by creating the data. Here's another one. Man, freaking Xcode. I upgraded Xcode today to 7.3. I wish I could go back to 7.2 at this point. Rocket Bunny, what's up, buddy? Today was awesome. I got my first Java project. What do you mean you got your first Java project? What'd you do? Tell us all about it. Foe, friend, neutral? I think this guy might be a neutral. I'm not sure. This mysterious warrior. I have no clue about him at this point. Empty. My teacher told us to make a program to make a calculator that calculates the area of various 2D shapes. And you did it in Java? Attaboy. Okay, cross your fingers. This might actually work. We'll see. So in this room, we should have it empty. Nope, not there. Oh, I haven't placed the tile yet. Oh, let me place the tile. Dang, man. Gotta place the tile, yo. Gotta place it right here. Tile Velle Warrior. This one's Tile Velle Empty. Let's hope it works. You're the only one in your class that knows how to do it? Whoa. All right, Avoxen. See you, man. Bye. Later. Thanks for dropping by. Yay. Look, it worked. We have an empty cryo chamber. This one, I don't want to have any bubbly glow particles. This one, I want to have the warrior, so it should have the bubbly glow particles. So let's take out the bubbly glow particles from the empty one. It should have the chamber, but not the beam or the beam two or the glow. So all it has is just the chamber. What am I working on? This is Velle's cave. This is a cave inside. It's somewhat close to the beginning of the game. So it's really close to your home screen. You find this cave. And inside this cave, there's this... Who is this? Who is this? Some character here. You'll be able to actually communicate with her. And eventually you free her from her cryo sleep by warping over here and setting off a bomb and stuff. Haven't done that part yet. Haven't got her to talk yet. but that's what I'm working on right now. And then this whole cave is actually full of two more interesting things. There's this empty cryo chamber here, which it's like, what's that? Who was in it? And this other one, we'll have a warrior inside it. Just somebody that you're like, who the heck is this? It's some mysterious warrior. All right, now the pattern for the empty one, I wanted to have a pathway on the bottom. So if the Y is less than H2, about less than or equal to, no, Y is less than the position P dot Y. Y is less than P dot Y, and X D is less than or equal to 1. We don't want to do sky. So that should leave a pathway across it. So somebody broke out of this thing and then yeah, that's better. So this one you can actually approach it. I might do one more so you can walk around it too. Let's do one more. Yeah, something like this. I just got to work on this sky tiles to make them look a little better. You can see there's a little point right here where it's just square. That's because I haven't finished those yet. All right, so yeah, now I can walk around this thing, and it's kind of even more mysterious. Like, what was here? What was this? So the next things on my list today are to start drawing. I want to draw the warrior that goes over here. I'll do that last, and then. But first, I want to. The focus here is Velle, so I want to make Velle. She needs to talk, but I also want to redo the art. The art for these cryo chambers is a bit old. I did it, you know, back in the day, and I kind of designed it for a different kind of screen. So I want to do some better art for this and make it more. Kind of fit into this world better. So I'm going to go ahead and save my point here. And I actually like what's been done so far, so I'm going to do another commit actually. We got the Velle Warrior, the Velle Empty, turning off plants. All right, let me get open this cryo art. Oh yeah, I forgot I was working on the position of these where the glow lines up. So let me line that up and then we'll actually work on the chamber itself, draw some better stuff. Okay. Wait, what was I supposed to check here? I forget. Oh, well. Oh, yeah, the way the glow lines up. Okay, so yeah, those dots way up there in the top of the screen. You can see the player's head is touching one right here. These two dots are not supposed to be there. I'm just using them to line it up. So they need to go up perhaps 5 or 6, and then to the right about 4. Jeez. So wait, hold on. If I go int.text. Yo, there we go. ENTX. I can get it faster. How about ETX? Ooh, that's pretty close too. Okay, I can work with this. I can work with Xcode 7.3. I can figure out how to make it work. The moment you jump directly in front of a neutron star while you were in brown draft systems for 20 minutes before, my eyes. Are you playing Elite Dangerous again? This is the glow for Vel. Glow position. All right, this is more like -9, and this is more like 10, -96 or so. You are. It's really bright then, I gather, when you go in front of the neutron star. That's close. We're talking like two more pixels up. Four more pixels up, actually, and maybe one to the left. Oh, ne negative one to the left would be -10. This would be -92. Sagittarius, cool. There we go. That's close enough. Those little dots are all lined up. Okay, let's get rid of the dots now. Just get rid of this layer. We've got all this. Let's re-export this glow. I want to double this glow up, actually. Actually, let's experiment with that. If I double this layer, it should be twice as twice as thick like that. And let's export this as sheets. This is a background called Cryo One Glow. Replace that. And if I build now, it should take a moment to rebuild those textures. Yeah, it's doing it. Right, let's see how that looks with the thicker glow. And then I'll start drawing the chamber and making it look cooler. Whoa, that's way bright. Dang, that's way too much. No worries. Let's turn off this extra layer then. Just re-export it how it was. Oh, and also update the position of this other glow thing. We should be back to how it was. Pro tip, don't try to refuel inside a neutron star. It hurts. Got it, buddy. I've noted this on my wall of notes. Don't refuel inside a neutron star. Badness will happen. Brighter so you can see it. Okay. Right, so now I want to imagine how this is going to look better. I want to take this cryo chamber and I want to make, first of all, I want to experiment with making it, redrawing it with stone. Everything else is kind of like got this stone look. So, but I don't want it to be the same color as all the rest of the stone. I want it to look like it's almost black stone, or maybe a dark purple stone, or something crazy alien. And then also, I want to give it some like, don't know, something. Maybe there should be some machinery in the corner or something like that that helps this whole cryo chamber do its cryo stuff. Price. Okay, I'll start experimenting with the look of that then. Alright, so we want to get this old chamber up. Just the outer glow. Seems really bright there, but. Nice one. I gotta rework this image a bit. Basically, I need everything above the chamber and everything below the chamber in different layers. Another group. This is the chamber. Alright, so now I should be able to turn off the top. This is like some random glowy stuff, and then turn off the background. We just have the chamber. Cool. Okay, so this is what I want to work on. Let's call this the background. This is the chamber. And this is the top stuff. I guess the outer glow can get rid of this not used glow. Hey, what's up, Zyanger? Yo, welcome, welcome. And I want to check something. Songbringer, bringer, sheets, backgrounds, cryo. I think the cryo chamber is a big, is it a big image? No. Not, it's like a small image. Open this. Yeah, it's just tiny. Okay, that works. Gotta remember to export that way. All right, let's draw this. All right, start making it look like stone. We need the right texture. Be a good place to start here. Either the mountains. Just the overworld mountains, I guess, would be a good start. Or the pillars. What's up, Dajmosek? Overworld, there it is. I should probably check this image in before I mess with it anymore. Background's hard to see. Alright, let's make it. I guess I'll just duplicate the layer, then I don't have to worry about destroying anything. Got some back glass. We'll keep that for now. Start drawing. So the top, basically everything that's this color, I want to make this color. I guess that color would be this color. This texture down here is a little too bright there. Have you considered tying the chamber to face left or right? Perfectly symmetrical and centered is boring sometimes. It's so funny, because you and I are of the same opinion there, but a lot of people like prefer the symmetry too, so. Sometimes I like to do the symmetry. Sometimes I like the asymmetry. What part exactly were you talking about tiling differently? Hello, Aesops. Welcome to the stream, man. Thanks for saying you're going to pre-order, man. Appreciate it. So are you talking about this? Somehow doing some asymmetry in this room? Or were you talking about this room or this room? Other room. Personally, I'm probably not going to worry too much about the asymmetry too much. Maybe like I could easily get some asymmetry going, like maybe taking the top quadrant and making it a little different or something. The chamber itself? Oh, this thing. Yeah. Oh, of course there'll be some asymmetry here. I thought you were talking about tiles or something. Oh, okay. Yeah, there's definitely going to be some asymmetry here. Let me play with this art and you'll see. Do 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 do. So I'm first thing I'm doing to this chamber is making it more of a stone-like structure than whatever this metal thing was, because I'm trying to unify the aesthetic of the game. I drew this art here you're seeing with the purple or whatever. I drew this a long time ago before I had really dialed in the aesthetic of the game and what, you know, what some characters, what kind of people the enemy is, you know, who is this crazy evil army and why are they so evil, what kinds of structures do they build, What kind of materials they use to build their structures. Okay, everything but this bottom looks good so far. I'm also gonna add some texturing on this too, so it'll look more like granite. Yeah, this inner chamber is still too bright for me. It's a little better. Whatever way I do this. Whoops. There we go. Yeah, that's looking better. And then we'll do a softer highlight for this part. Yeah, nice. And then a brighter highlight up here on the top. This is like the sparkly bits of the granite showing through, you know, like the quartz and stuff. Let's go with a little bit of asymmetry here. I think I'm actually gonna gonna color this background better. Oops. This is background layer. Where is it at? There's back glass. This thing's 29%. Let's put it all the way. There we go. Glass color. If there even is glass. There we go. Okay, so let's add some granite texturing to the top now. Alrighty, Sops. Thanks, man. Yeah, thanks, and we'll see you later, man. The player enters through a door to the side of the room it'll be in, right? No, they enter from the below. What if the entire thing was tiled, tilted to face whatever direction they come in from by a few pixels? That'd be interesting, maybe for the other ones. Let me show you the three different chambers here. So there's Velle. I'm working on her art and stuff like that for her chamber now. So this is the whole cave here. You come in from outside, and There's this connector room here. This is going to be an empty cryo chamber. There's nobody in it yet. So this one right here might be a good example of something I could just twist it a little bit. That's a good idea. Thanks, Mutinous. That's actually a really great idea to mess up the art just a little bit, you know, twist it a bit. And same thing with this one. We could make this slightly rotated as well. I'll play with that. But first I'm going to finish her cryo chamber up here. Mr. Hepf, any thoughts, advice on the factory pattern? Just found out I probably need to implement it. I do have some thoughts for you. First of all, yes, in general, design patterns are going to make your code better. What they're going to make your code, you know, they're going to make your code more cohesive, basically. And if it's not, if a design pattern is not making your code more cohesive, then it's not a good design pattern to be using. So what you want to always do is focus on making your code more cohesive. And you can look this up on Wikipedia, what cohesion is. In fact, here, I'll post these links because these are well worth reading. And then there's also coupling. You always want to make sure your code is not being coupled. You want to have no coupling going on whatsoever in your code ever. And you always want to make your code cohesive. So the whole point of design patterns is basically to make your code more cohesive. And, sorry those links got broken. But I hope you can find them. But I would my second part of my advice here is I would question yourself whenever you think you probably need to do something. I've found in my own personal development, you know, developing games over 20 years, is that whenever I catch myself using the word should, like, oh, I should do that. And in your case, you're saying it just a little bit differently. You're saying I probably need to do that. Question it. Okay. Why is it that you probably need to do that pattern? Maybe you have a good reason. Maybe you don't. Maybe you don't have a good reason at all. But maybe you do. Maybe it's a great reason and you need to do it. Just what you need to do is just kind of search yourself in your mind and understand why it is that you want to do what you're doing, because it will probably help you do it even better. I hope that all made sense and didn't... I hope I the point got made there, I guess. Okay, so let's make this a little less... let's do some more asymmetry here. Looks more stone-like, you know? What was that? Why is that darker? Did that help there, Mr. Hepf? I plan on using the factory pattern to create the actions that my creatures use. The actions that your creatures use, the factory pattern. Okay. In my code, an action is a thing that contains events that get scheduled to occur at a time in the future. Okay, so I'm trying to make it so that creating an action walk for a wolf, I can just specify the direction, and the factory can tell the walk what map the wolf is on and where the map is. Pedro, we'll see you, man. Have a good night. Yeah, I hope things go well with your supervisor and your thesis and everything. Does that make it a good enough reason? Mr. Hepf, in the end, you're really the only one that can determine that, because you're the one that knows your code and everything. But let me give you some more things to explore so you can figure that out for yourself. You really, It might take a week. It might take you a week to kind of like, because it took me a whole week to understand all these concepts and stuff and decide the best choice to make for my game when I first started Songbringer. But let me give you some really cool things to check out. You should definitely check out entity component systems. Here's a link from Ray Wenderlich. Raylan Wenderlich does like a bunch of different like game development tutorials for like Cocos 2D and stuff, and which is a. Anyways, the point is, this is an entity component systems will simplify your games. You might not need to even use the factory pattern if you're using an entity component system. This could simplify everything for you. Check this out to this link here. But anyways, when I first started learning about them, I had to really digest the information for what the heck an entity component system is and why to use it. Your game currently uses a bastardized version of an entity component. Great. You're already on the path. So my question for you is to think about that. Why are you even considering using a factory pattern if you have an entity component system? Oh, the entities contain the components, huh? Well, I mean, yeah, that's a different kind of design for an entity component system, I guess, but it might work. But yeah, it just I don't know, just kind of, I guess would just my question for you is just to think about things a little bit and then, but in the end, really, it doesn't really matter that much, you know? Just what's more important is making games, I think, than making games perfect, you know? So I don't know. Maybe those thoughts help you a little bit. Maybe they don't. I don't know. Scottish Pizza, what's up, man? How you doing? How's today? So I want to get the granite texture. You made a thing. Zynger made a thing. You made a thing on YouTube? Hey, sweet. Oh, this is your procedural stuff. Sweet. I'm not getting any sound on this. Yeah. Look at that, 60 FPS with 1400 entities. Wow. Okay, cool. Everybody's on fire. It's a procedural island generator with some forests and animals. You can set everything on fire. Cool. That's really awesome, man. I like it. Mr. Hef, I'm not tied to it right now. I was just scared of going full entity component to start off. Oh, why are you scared, man? Really, I should give you some encouragement here because entity component systems have changed the way I think about games completely, and I will never ever go back to not using a proper entity component system ever again. They simplify games completely. The whole point is to take away code from many different, and if you have all these different entities, when you design things without an entity component system or with an entity component system, maybe that's not designed very well, you're designing games by writing a lot of code for every single entity. And the whole point of an entity component system is to place code in the proper place. You want your entities to be simply just integers. You want your components to be purely data, not code, if possible. And you want your systems to have all the code. So what that does is like I said, it makes cohesive code. A full entity component system makes your coding cohesive because all of your programming and your code and your go in the systems and all your data goes in. It's just like the MVC pattern, the model view container. And you're looking into design patterns right now, which is awesome. You're on the right path, man. So maybe an entity component system is for you at this point. Maybe it's not. But all I want to do is just encourage you to check it out, you know, and try a full entity component system. But maybe not. Maybe you don't need to right now. I don't know. It's up to you. Would I advise creating one from scratch or using a pre-existing one? Personally, I would advise creating your own from scratch or looking at one that really inspires you. Maybe mine does. I don't know. Maybe it doesn't. But there's Entity Foo. Maybe you already have the link to this. I don't know. But I'll just post it again anyways. Here's the Entity Component System I wrote for Songbringer. And there is a C-sharp one. I think somebody made a C-sharp version of Entity Foo. Yeah, Boogie did. That's right. Boogie ported to C-sharp. Let's check out Boogie's version of Entity Foo. You almost blew up your spaceship? Scottish Pizza, man, I'm doing good. All right, see you, pizza. Later, man. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Do I recommend any specific ones? I definitely would recommend Entity Foo because it's very simple. Check out Entity Foo's code. It's like one header file, one C++ file. That's you know, I like keeping things simple myself, and I like to code things with very simple things like Entity Foo. Entity Foo's, check out. I'll show you some of the more important methods of Entity Foo. See, this is an entity. All an entity is an unsigned integer. That's all an entity is. A component is a structure for holding data, only data, no code. That's the point. And then systems run everything else. So here's the entity component, and here's like an example system. And anyways, you can check out the example if you check out this code or whatever. If you get the project, it's got some an example Xcode project, but you can make your own project anyways without the Xcode. It has a main.cpp. Okay, so yeah, I was gonna open this up and grab the granite texture. I have it in this old. Oh yeah, cave squared. The very first original image, except for him holding in the shirt. My game is grid-based. Would the individual tiles be entities in this system? It depends. You could do it both ways. You could still keep your tile system, or you can use your tile system and base that off of that and create an entity for every different tile. So. Yes, actually, you probably would just want to, if you're using a grid-based system, you'd probably want to convert every one of your tiles into an entity. And that's what's going on in Songbringer. It uses a tile-based grid system to generate everything. And then off of that grid system, it creates an entity for every one of the tiles. See, these little red areas show you where some of the tiles are. And so, I mean, some of the entities. Everything that has a red square is a separate entity. And there, if I go to this mode, you can see a little bit more. So yeah, I personally, I mean, yeah, if you, yeah, I would do that. I would change your engine to use entities myself. It makes things more flexible. For example, in Songbringer, check this out. Before, I simply just had these normal pillars, right? But because I'm using an entity component system, I could easily at some point go, all right, I want this pillar to have a little more intelligence. I want it to be able to be hit by the sword and come back. And that's just all changing the data for that entity rather than changing the code at all for this yet another entity. You don't want to go and rewrite code, you know? Cohesive. Where's that layer for? There it is. Luckily, my game logic is in its own, so I'll make a branch switching to Entity Component System. All right, good. Oh, nice, man. I'm glad I convinced you because I really think you will find an amazing thing here with a full-blown entity component system, especially if you're kind of like either using a really simple one or writing one your own that's really simple and works in the way that you prefer, you know? Space my name. I'm on desktop and I got a small album of gifts for you. Oh, thanks, man. But I'm working on the cave for Velle right now. Ooh, sweet gifts, man. Random solar systems. Flipping through seeds. Ooh, texture for a star. What are these, Zanger? I mean, space my name? Is this the game you're working on? It's cool. I typically put this texture usually around like 2% or so. Yeah, that's good. That's like 7%. That's still looking pretty good though, but it's still a little lower. Yeah, like 6% or so. That's good. All right, let's see what this looks like in the game with a more stone-like cryo chamber. I'll turn off this background and that. And I think I might have to, I don't want to have to change the, I guess I have to. Let's re-export that as cryo one chamber. And we probably want to color it as code or as, it's the chamber render color type is going to be rock. Same for these other cryo chambers. Color type rock. Color type rock. Is the Microsoft Entity Framework a good starting place? I don't know. I haven't checked it out. Really, the best framework for you is going to be one that really gels with you. So what I would do is check out the headers, man. Check out the headers. And check out any example projects the Entity Component System is going to have. And also check out those articles. You really want to do a good job of understanding Entity Component Systems more than anything at this point. Really, you should understand firmly why you would want to use one. You want to understand kind of how they work in general and how you might rework your game to use one. And it may take a few days to process that kind of information, you know, and like get it. You know, think about your best entity component system to use and how you would implement it in your game. And I really think investing a few days into that right now will really help you out down the road. Like you might spend a week right now making your game more entity component system based, and I swear that will come back to you later as so much time saved in your game's project. I'm assuming that your game is longer than a 3-month project, because if your game is like a really, really quick game that you're supposed to get out in like less than 3 months, maybe an entity component system might not be the best thing, but it's very good for a long-term game development. Nice, the game you told, sweet, you're working on the Bellatrix system, sweet, nice. You've written everything so far with the assumption that I might switch to a full entity, okay, nice. All right, so you're already on that track, man. Good. I'm glad. I'm glad you're on that track, and I'm also glad that maybe I'm pushing you a little bit more to go all the way with it. I think you'll really find it to be quite rewarding. Okay, yeah, I'm liking this. This looks a lot better with the stone cryo chamber, and I want to try a little bit of color in the chamber, either a bluish or a purplish color for these chambers. might take the background. I might take away that windshield or whatever that is in the background, but maybe not. Voice of Grog, greetings. All right, I could just play with this art right here if I want to do a hue shift on it. All right, I'm thinking darker and slightly saturating or making it not green, maybe blue or purple. One of the, yeah, in here. Let's try bluish purple there. Let's see what that looks like, because it's also going to combine with the rock color. I don't know, Kev. What's up, man? Hello. Naloth, is Photoshop free? No. I'm still early in the project anyway, only 1,200 lines of code. All right, good, 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 man. You're at just the perfect place to be doing what you're doing right now. I'm excited for you. I'm really excited for what you find here with your next steps, and I'd love to hear how it goes for you with the Entity Component System being full-blown or what you end up doing, you know? Yeah, love to hear. I think I want the edges of this container. Different. So how do these chambers look with the darker color? Yeah, they're a little too dark now, but I kind of like the hue. I like seeing them with a slightly different hue, but the lightness needs to be different, like maybe -5 max. How are we doing on time today? Oh, almost done with the stream. It's already been 2 hours. Can you believe it? It's already been 2 hours. I like this. I like seeing a slight color to that. It makes it different. It makes it look more important almost. I like that. Yeah, that blue looks really good too. So the blue is 174. I'm gonna experiment with some other colors though. Maybe like yellow or green would look cool too, who knows. This is more reddish. More, yeah, reddish. Yeah, let's try this red color. See what that looks like. Hell, maybe they all have different colors. What's the command for the points? You mean to raffle or to show your points? How does that look? That's supposed to be, yeah, that kind of looks cool too, the red. Actually, that red does look really neat. Huh. I'm kind of thinking I should do three different chambers, all with unique lettering and stuff. So this was -38. And then the other one was 174. So there I've got both of these in this document here, but I want to go to the, let's close this one. No need that. Don't need the overworld. Keep sky open for now, but cryo one, I can do I can make this its own layer here. I can start a newer layer. Yeah, let's do slices. So close, yet so far away. You're close to 50% chance, space my name. So 2,000 points if you raffle it for a Steam key. 2,000 points give you a 50% chance of winning a Steam key. Oh, wait. Oh, Teak, you just bet. Oh, Teak, so close. But yeah, I see what you're saying by so far away. Here, let me hold on, Teak. Let me give you another start here. You did lose. You lost with a 70% chance. Oh, dude. Here, I feel sorry for you. Here, let me give you a start. Is good odds, but like Tika said, it is an actual random number, so you never know whether you're gonna lose or whether you're gonna win. Great, now I can get two more of these chambers. And they should all have this texture as well. All right, so yeah, I'm almost done with the stream here, guys. What's up, Bullseye Pie? Hello, Tom Servos. Does it go up exponentially? No, it doesn't. It's linear. So by the time you get if you raffle off with 4,000 points, you get have a close to 100%, either 100% or close to 100%. I'm not sure if it's like 99. So we'll make this a layer-based slice, and is it this one? Nope, it's this one. This one a layer-based slice. Yeah. Okay, now I'm just name these layers. Oh, I gotta duplicate the back too. Can't forget the back. So if you're just tuning in right now, I'm working on this cave. Actually, I'm pretty much done. I gotta get some dinner and stuff. You get the game free and then buy it on Steam later. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. I'm just gonna recap what I've been doing today. I'm working on this chamber here, this cave for Velle. I'll show you from the entrance of this cave what this is gonna be like. Velle is an NPC. She's important to the plot of the game. She's a warrior from the previous great war that happened on this planet. There's the entrance to this cave. This is going to be a cryo chamber where there's this broken, like you'll see just the edges of it all cracked and stuff or something. So it looks like somebody broke out of that cryo chamber. And then this one over here is going to have another warrior floating here. Some kind of like cool looking something just floating in cryo sleep there. And then up here, there's Velle. She's floating, and you'll be able to actually communicate with her and stuff. So, yeah, that's it for today's stream. Have I tried app code? No, I haven't tried that. It looks great, though. Do you know anything about Entitas or Artemis? No, I've heard of Artemis. It looks all right. But all the entity component systems that I did research on all look too complicated for me. And that's why I wanted to create my own. That's why I created EntityFoo. So check them out, man. Check them out and see what works for you. So, yeah, that's it for today's stream. I'll be back again probably tomorrow, most likely. And once again, same wizard time. I'm always here about 2 to 4 p.m. Pacific. And that's it for today's stream of Songbringer. We'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.